Hi there, welcome to Age&Opportunity. For more information about our organisation, please see our website details, which should be at the bottom of the screen now. This is the first of a series of videos that we're producing about being creative at home, using everyday materials. And today, we're going to be looking at how to use this, bubble wrap. If you're like me, there's always some around the house because I keep it, because I know that there'll be some use for it later. And today, Tom Meskell, who is one of our visual arts facilitators on our Creative Exchanges programme, is going to show us ways of really making some really beautiful things that we can either, you know, keep and hang them up around the house, or indeed use them as gifts to give to other people. Over the next few Saturdays, he and his wife Carmel are going to really lead us all in a range of activities, showing us how to be more creative at home, and really, more importantly, to have fun. I really hope you enjoyed the video, and and hope to see you next week as well. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Now, hello, everybody. I'm Tom. This is Carmel, my lovely wife.
Hello, everybody.
We are stuck in the house like everybody else. We're both artists. Well, I do lots of visual art, and Carmel is
a puppeteer
and an excellent one at that. Welcome to my studio in the west of Ireland. I don't live too far from Knock Airport, and so that's a little bit of Mayo you're seeing out the window. So what we have laid out here, very easy to find things. Bubble wrap, which I've stuck down to the table. I'll show you later how I've done this. I've got some sycamore leaves. I have poster paint, which is like water washable. If it gets in your clothes, it'll all wash out. And you can get it in a lot of shops. It's very easy to buy. You know, kids use it a lot. So what we're going to do is something that is one of my favorite workshops to do, and I know people usually enjoy it, and it's bubble wrap printing. And it's super simple. You don't have to get caught up on making a beautiful piece of art. What happens is the paint sits on the tops of the bubbles, and you get a print. Pointillism is a form of art where you make it out of loads of dots. So that's kind of what you're doing, but it tends to look like mosaic. It's really nice. This is brown wallpaper lining. You can buy it in a hardware shop really easily. It's very cheap as well. And to do a kind of a fancier print of a piece of watercolor paper, which you usually buy in art shops, but you can get in some bargain shops as well. Okay, so I'm going to work as quick as I can. So you can see I'm being very generous. I'm just getting the colour down. I want it to be nice and wet. It's very important. I'm going to try and cover the entire piece of bubble wrap with paint. And I want it to be, you want to work quickly, in fact, because you want the paint to stay wet so you can get your print. So I'm being very random. As you get into it and you see the limitations and all of that, you'll kind of change the way you work. But you can get great effects from it. It's lovely as well for making cards and things like that. And it's quick. And once you have it laid out and you refresh the paint, you could get a few prints off each piece of bubble wrap. So you could kind of do a few pieces together, if you know what I mean. You get a few for the price of one. Okay. And I've kind of, there's been a bit of a method in my madness here. I've laid the colours out. I've got yellow, red, blue, green, and white. And the reason for that is I wanted, and I'm sure a lot of you know this already. Oh, look, I'm after doing the red and green of Mayo by accident. Well, yeah, that's the homage to the county now. But the reason I did that is that the primary colours are blue, yellow, and red. And technically, out of those colours, you can make all of the colours. So if you're feeling a bit short on paint or money, you can just buy blue, yellow, red. I'd always get white. It's good to have white. Now, So I'll quickly go through colour mixing as I'm doing this. So to get purple, it would be blue with a teensy bit of red. So you see I'm getting the blue there and a tiny bit of red in there. So you're getting a purple colour. I hope that's coming through on the camera. A bit of white will turn it into a kind of a lilac colour. And green is made from blue and yellow. So you can see that there, kind of magically appearing. So that's pure yellow, and I've got blue already on my brush, and you get green. And the more yellow you have, you get a kind of a brighter lime green, which is a kind of real spring green, I think. You do actually go through a good bit of paint. So because I'm printing on a brownie colour, you feel free to use lots of white. But if you're printing onto a white piece of paper, you're as well not to use, just use white as a mixer. Did you see the dog there? That's Sweetie the dog. She was a bit bonkers, but she's getting better the older she gets. Thank God. She had everything eaten. Every shoe in the house had been chewed. But thank God those days are going. So I'm going to add a little bit more white here. It does use like a good bit of paint. I'm going to use a lot more yellow because I like the brightness of the yellow. And you can kind of, don't, as I said, I'm not worried about making a like a landscape or anything like that. I'm just concerned about getting colours I like. I'm throwing them down. I'm not worrying about it. Like there's nothing, don't be precious about it. Just have fun with it. You can really lash in. And what we often do in the workshops, there could be three or four of us working on the one. So if there's more than one of you in the house, you can just be having a bit of fun. That's my wife there, Carmel. She's lost something. And I'll keep flying away here. Yeah. And it's fun because you get to mix the colours as you go and see how different colours work with each other. And I'm sure you're wondering, of all these materials I've laid out, why do I have leaves on the table? And I'm going to show you that now. Okay, I'm nearly there. Okay, last bit. I'm just going to put a little bit more white around to kind of break up the monotone just of the red there. Gonna make it a bit pinky, a bit perky. Now, here we go, lovely. Okay, that has it as I want it. I'm going to put this to the side. Going to get my sheet of brown paper. So with the curved side inwards, now I'm going to give it a nice rub on. Now, I'm going to peel off. Whoa. Isn't that fun? And you can do smaller pieces, of course. I'll put that there for the moment. So here's a smaller piece of paper. I'm going to just give it a little refresh. So I took a print off it, so it's going to be a bit dry now. I'm just going to give it a bit of a refresh. My leftover colour is working very fast. Try and keep the wetness. I can just I'm going to select a kind of a smaller section. And I'm going to show you what you can do with the leaves. These are sycamore leaves from our garden. Everything's just beginning to grow, which is wonderful. My two leaves. And what we're doing here, there's a term in art and we call it the negative space. So what will happen is it'll print everything except the leaves I've put down. So we'll see if it works out. It's a bit of an experiment. So you can kind of see the idea. We get the white spaces where we put the leaves. So you'd be able to use different shapes. You could cut out pieces of cardboard to get those shapes. And just to show you quickly how we do this, I use the scissors to cut out the bubble wrap. So let's say you've got a square of bubble wrap this size. And then using the masking tape, you can use sellotape if that's all you have. Masking tape I find handier because you don't need the scissors. You can just tear it like this. So it's kind of handier from that point of view. And it comes off the table fairly easy. But the normal sellotape will be fine. So that's how you stick it on your table. Now, I hope you've enjoyed that. Very simple, very quick, and it's great fun. And you can get your pieces and you could cut them up smaller and then stick them onto cards and make nice cards for people, or frame them. You can buy frames in some of the shops that already have the mounting on them, so if you did them to the right size, you'd have a really nice simple gift for somebody, and they look beautiful from a distance, and it makes it look like you've done all those dots yourself. So it's a great trick. Okay, everybody, thank you so much for joining me and stay safe. God bless. Bye bye.
So we've come to the end of video one. I really hope you've enjoyed it and hope that you're going to get excited about, you know, looking around, using materials around the house and indeed sometimes from the garden. Next week, we're going to be looking at using watercolor pencils. Now, these are readily available and in fact, they're not expensive and you can get them in lots of discount stores. So if you can get out, maybe have a look for them or ask somebody else to go and get some for you as well. And if you can get your hands on some watercolor paper, that would be excellent. Take care and see you next week. Thank you. Bye-bye.